begin with you. It's my opinion that liberals on college campuses now resemble Islamist mobs, where they riot over rhetoric. You remember in Iraq and Afghanistan, whenever there was an affront to Islam or Islam was challenged, they'd burn the flag and they'd riot and break things. Now, on the left, on college campuses, when liberalism is perceived to be under attack, they riot, they burn things, and they hurl expletives and cause complete chaos. Isn't that just childish?
No, and Jesse, I'm a little surprised. You know, when you look at a school like Berkeley, which represents the brightest and the best of American college students, these are people who are expressing a disappointment with extreme views on the right. And even people on the right disagree with some of the views that are being put out by the Breitbart editor. My point is simply this. This is a voting bloc that we're talking about. These are people at Berkeley that are going to be voting in the midterm election, and they cannot be ignored. They're not the professional protesters that you want to characterize them. These are students.
Leo, you said that they're expressing disappointment. Now, when I express disappointment, maybe I shrug my shoulders or I complain a little bit. I don't throw things through windows of private property. And another thing, I don't know if all these people are going to be voting because the other mob that came out after the election that was rioting and protesting and burning things on the West Coast, half of them never even voted in the general. So I don't see these people as engaged voters. I just see them as rabble-rousers. Adriana, you would have to admit that the more the left goes crazy like this, that Donald Trump comes out looking reasonable and mature.
Yeah, absolutely, because we know that all of Donald Trump's supporters, you know, value the Constitution and our right to free speech. And we see our basic civil liberties, our right to free speech, being trampled on college campuses all across this country. And it's so dangerous. And we've been seeing this trend for over 10 years now, but now it's actually gotten so violent. I mean, if you look at the riots that took place at Berkeley, there was $100,000 worth of damage and windows smashed, things set on fire. These are criminals. Someone would even go as far as saying these aren't particularly voters, terrorists.
Okay, let's draw a distinction between criminals and students, people expressing their First Amendment right. I am not going to condone the violence, but you're not going to sit there and broad stroke that everyone who are protesting against Donald Trump, they're wrong. Everybody who supports Donald Trump is right. That's a tremendous broad stroking,
well, no,
and I think you're disingenuous in that position. It's very wrong.
Look, I support peaceful protest. That's allowed per the Constitution. But when you vandalize a building, that's a criminal act. So you're going to be charged with criminal charges. Arson is a criminal charge. So these are not peaceful protesters. These are thugs and criminals who belong in jail.
Leo.
And they should
pay for their damages.
The $100,000 in damages.
Let me just say something. It's very hard to come out as a leftist and say that Trump is this rude guy who's prone to violence and then act yourself rude and engage in violence during the protests. It doesn't serve your interests.
Jesse, let me look at the broad stroking that you and Andrea is pointing out. First of all, college campuses, all liberals. Well, you know what? It's funny. Your Fox colleague, Greg Gutfeld, came from Berkeley as well. And my point is simply this, that nothing, the argument of these college campuses and these youth expressing a viewpoint, what is wrong with that? Trump has to worry about a blowback at the midterm
election. Wait a second. You know what's wrong with it? When you're throwing things through buildings and you're lighting things on
fire. I'm not going to condone the violence.
If I was a citizen in Berkeley and my store got crashed into by some radical, I'd be pretty angry. And politics is about persuasion. I don't think people are persuading other people. If they're holding up airport lines at JFK or LAX or torching someone's limousine like they did in the D.C. inauguration, that's not necessarily getting people to come to your side.
I'm not gonna defend that. That's the misdirection of this argument. The argument is very simple. Civil disobedience has been part of this country's history. And more importantly, people are expressing, Jesse and Andrea, an outrage at the extreme arguments that Trump supporters are using. Trump is providing cover for the extreme right. And the extreme right is under his umbrella. And that is what these protesters are articulating.
The only extreme I see is on the left, because they've been responsible for almost every act
Jesse.
Of violence since the election.
Did you hear what you just said?
Last word, Adriana.
Yeah, Absolutely. I mean, what's happening here is the left is censoring conservative speech. I mean, Leo, you can't defend that. Our rights are being violated. I mean, these speakers are being, you know, shut out. They're not able to express their First Amendment rights. I mean, you know that that's wrong.